Archie and Edith. Their secrets, their fears, and triumphs became ours. But like most of television, they spoke, and you listened. In preparing this show, we wondered what people would have said to the Bunkers if they'd had the chance. A decade of controversy, as you might imagine, generated a lot of letters. So we contacted a number of you who wrote us all those years ago and sent our cameras across America to Florida, Missouri, New England, Illinois, and in between to speak with people who retained their passion for All in the Family, both pro and con. Their observations, we felt, are far richer than anything we could offer. So as we move on, listen as America talks back to the Bunkers.
Yeah, I can see where some folks may have been offended by some of Archie's feelings, his bigotry.
Even though it was a sitcom, it offended me.
I am a Christian, and I don't believe in profanity, vulgarity like that, especially on TV.
A lot of times after an episode of All in the Family, you would look during the current week and say, gee, am I really like that? And of course, a lot of us are like that.
It had a tremendous impact. It was like giving somebody castor oil that tasted good. I mean, it really did taste good.
It said things that had been taboo and that nobody openly talked about, and there it was on television, and that's great.
Ma, something's wrong. I know you.
Why does everybody around here think they know me? Remember, Gloria, deep waters run very still. But, Ma, I know me a lot longer than you have, so don't go around saying you know me.
Okay. Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to upset you.
I got a lump in my breast.
What did you just say?
I got a lump.
Oh,
in...
Mama.
That's the first time I said it out loud.
I mean, my grandmother had breast cancer, so it's something that actually touched, you know, our family, and the way it was dealt with on the show was similar to the way it was dealt with in my family.
I'm afraid if I have this operation, Archie won't think of me in the same way.
Oh, Edith, stop scaring yourself. Archie loves you, and nothing's gonna change that.
But I'm gonna change a lot.
Listen, even if you have to have the operation, it's still gonna be all right. Believe me.
You don't know.
That's just the point, Edith. I do know. I know.
You mean you?
6 years ago. And you see how Frank and I get along? It hasn't made one bit of difference in our marriage. Don't bother looking, Edith. You can't tell, and there's no use asking me.
Oh, no, I wouldn't think of asking. I mean, I think of it, but I wouldn't ask. Oh, Irene, you made me feel so much better.
Menopause. I think that was one of the funniest episodes I ever saw in my life, but my heart bled for Edith.
Oh, wait till I show you. There's one of them in here, an all-bare band.
A naked band at Disneyland?
No. You know, bears, like brown bears, grizzly bears.
Well, I hate bears.
Yeah, but they ain't real bears, Edith. Look.
I hate all bears. Take it away.
I'm just trying to show you something.
Stifle!
Perhaps because I was going through it about the same time she was, when she was going through the change of life, he was heartless.
I know all about your woman's troubles there, Edith, but when I had the hernia that time, I didn't make you wear the truss.
Come on, Archie.
No, Edith. If you're gonna have a change of life, you gotta do it right now. I'm gonna give you just 30 seconds. Now come on, change.
For me, it was such a relief in my own family that subjects we didn't talk about were being talked about on that show that we all sat around the TV to watch.
What are you going to do to me?
Just exactly what you think I'm going to do to you.
No, you wouldn't do that. No, you wouldn't.
I will.
No.
Knock it off. All right. Just stay quiet, okay?
gonna do? You ain't taking off your clothes, are you?
Yeah. Then I'm gonna take yours off.
Wouldn't you like a cup of coffee?
I don't drink coffee.
I got Sanka.
Lady, you're stalling. It ain't gonna do you any good. And this is gonna happen. So just relax, okay?
Oh, listen, I gotta get out of here. See, I gotta get ready for my birthday party.
Happy birthday.
Oh, thank you.
Really glad.
Now, wait a minute.
What?
Couldn't we do this without kissing?
Yeah, okay. But you're gonna change your mind.
Oh, there's something burning in the kitchen.
What is it?
It's in the kitchen.
All right. Come on.
There's something burning in the kitchen. Oh, there's a fire! Fire! What? Oh, my birthday cake! My birthday cake is burning!
Lady, get rid of it.
All in the Family 20th Anniversary Special, sponsored by McDonald's. Always good food, always good value.
Of all the nations in the world, send me your poor, your deadbeats, your filthy. And all the nations sent them in here. They come swarming in like ants. Your Spanish PRs from the Caribbean. Your Japs, your Chinamen, your Krauts and your Heaves, and your Lincoln's Pants. Come in here, and they're all free to live in their own separate sections. Where they feel safe, and they bust your head if you go in there. That's what makes America great, buddy.
I think in America, people just keep insulting each other. Someone
not
else
really
insults
meaning.
Someone else.
Not really meaning. Then again, you say if you don't really mean it, you shouldn't even say it. But this is the American way. What do you want to do?
Poor old Arch. It came to passing along knowledge. I think he was bankrupt in that department.
Hold it! What are you doing here? Why? What about the other foot? There ain't no sock on it. I'll get to it. Don't you know that the whole world puts on a sock and a sock and a shoe and a shoe? I like to take care of one foot at a time. That's the dumbest thing I ever heard in my life. It's just as quick my way.
Wait a minute, that ain't the prank.
You see what I told? Don't keep doing it. Listen to me.
Suppose there's a fire in the house and you got to run for your life. Your way, all you got on is one shoe and a sock. My way, you got on a sock and a sock. You see, you're even.
Suppose it's raining or snowing outside. Your way with a sock on each foot, my feet would get wet. My way with a sock and a shoe on one foot, I could hop around and stay dry.
Wait a minute, listen to me. Supposing the other sock's got a hole in it.
It doesn't have a hole in it.
I said supposing
right,
it's got a hole.
It has a hole.
All right, it's got a hole in it. So, you ain't got another matching pair, so what are you gonna do? Your way, you gotta take off a whole shoe and a sock. My way, all you gotta do is take off one sock.
All right, if it'll make you happy, I'll start all over again.
No, you're halfway through now. Gee, get on with it, we're in a hurry. You can start doing it the right way tomorrow morning.
And do it that way for the rest of your life.